Assalamualaikum to all of you. Welcome back to our lecture. So for today, we are going to discuss new chapter under negotiable instruments. Right? So we hold for a while chapter of law of agency because I need to explain to you regarding the negotiable instruments for the purpose of your second assignment. Okay, based on your syllabus, negotiable instruments will only cover on check. Okay, so you have to understand the specifically the relevant rules to govern on check. Okay, so what is a negotiable instrument? Basically, negotiable instruments are governed by the Bills of Exchange Act 1949, revised 1976. So, the provisions regarding check also governed by this act. Okay. So, negotiable instrument means a document containing an undertaking to pay a definite sum of money which may be transferred by delivery or by endorsement and delivery. This is basically an options, okay, given to the buyer. Okay, first option is to pay for the goods via cash. Okay, but if the buyer choose to use a negotiable instruments, for example, he may use bills of exchange, check, promissory notes, okay, and other types of negotiable instruments. Okay, next. This is the learning outcome for today's lecture. First of all, at the end of the lesson today, student is able to define check and its characteristics. And then student is able to identify the crossings of check and its effects. Okay, take note, this is very important for you to know what are the crossings of check and what types of crossing we have. Okay, and then student is able to explain on alteration of check. And last but not least is to discuss the protection given to paying and collecting banker. Okay, later on I explain to you briefly the definitions of paying and collecting banker. Alright, move on to the definitions of check. Check is defined under Section 73 of the Bills of Exchange Act 1949, revised 1978. Okay, so if you notice, the same statute used for negotiable instruments. Okay, but this provision, Section 73, defines check as a bill of exchange drawn on a banker and payable on demand. Okay, you cannot have your own check without stating the name of banker. Okay, because the check will becomes what we call it as the check will has no value. Okay, if it is not drawn on a banker, and then when you drawn check, it means that your check is payable on demand. Okay. Alright, move on to the types of crossings. Okay, what is the purpose of crossing? Why we need to cross the check? Okay, it is to make it difficult, okay, though not possible for an authorized person, okay, unauthorized person, such as a rogue, to obtain payment across the counter, meaning that to protect the safety of our check, so that other person who is not the owner of check can obtain payment across the counter. Okay, so take note, this is unauthorized. Okay, it is referred to unauthorized person. Okay. It is because a cross check can only be paid through bank. Okay, so bank has a power to pay for the cross check. Okay, so based on bills of exchange act, there are two types of cruising. Okay, we have a general cruising and special cruising. So what is general cruising? This is when two parallel transverse lines drawn across the face of the check based on section 76 subsection 1. Okay, take note, there must be two parallel transverse lines. And usually it consists words such as a co, non-negotiable, or account payee. So if you found a check, okay, we've crossed these words, okay, this is means general crossing of check. So by virtue of section 76, a person may cross the check to add the words not negotiable. So what are the effects if you cross not negotiable on your check? The check lost the full character of negotiability, meaning that your check cannot be negotiated, but it remains transferable. So who can transfer your check? The owner, okay, but it cannot negotiate. Negotiate here means that you cannot have any dealing with the check. For example, okay, if a person steal your check, okay, he cannot negotiate with the check. He cannot use the check in order to pay for his own goods because it lost the characteristic of negotiability. And then second effect, if the title of the transferor is defective, it will affect the title of the transferee even though he may not know the defect. Okay, first you must understand who is a transferor. Transferor is orang yang transfer check to other person. Okay, and the other person here is referring to transferee. So if the transferor stole the check, maksudnya check tu adalah check curi, and then he transferred to transferee, then transferee will receive defect title. Okay, even though he may not know the defect, even dia tak tahu yang check tu adalah check curi. Okay. Okay, example of case for general cruising, we have a case of Wilson and Mason against Pickering. In this case, Wilson drew a check in blank, crossed not negotiable, and his clerk was supposed to fill in the amount and the name of the payee, inserted a sum in excess of her authority. Okay, now the clerk exceeds of her own authority, and then she delivered the check to Pickering in payment of her own debt. Okay, so based on the facts given here, the clerk used the check that belonged to Wilson in order to pay her own debt. And the court held that since the clerk had no title to the check, therefore Pickering had no better title than the clerk did, and therefore Wilson was not liable for it. So in this situation, who is a transferor? Transferor here is the clerk, and then transferee is Pickering. So transferee will receive no better title, okay, other than the transferor has. Okay, next, fraud can be minimized by cruising the check to add the words account payee only. Okay, just now you cross the words not negotiable, okay, but you can also cross the word account payee only. And what are the effects? The collecting banker has to credit the check into the account of the payee. Okay, account of payee here is the name of payee, okay, that has been written on the check. Okay, and then the collecting banker will be guilty of negligence and liable to the true owner for the amount of the check if he disregards the crossings. In other words, collecting banker will only pay the check to the account payee name on the check. Okay. So in example, case of Woodland Development Sdn Bhd against Chartered Bank, PJTB dan Sens M Sdn Bhd. Okay, the defendant bank was liable for negligence in collecting the two account paychecks for a third party who was not the pay name on the check. In this case, okay, the collecting banker was liable because they had paid to the wrong person. Okay, who are the names not crossed on the check? Okay, who are not referring to the account payee name on the check? Okay, however, the liability for negligence can be rebutted if the collecting banker proved that he has made proper inquiry as to the authority or title of the person into whose account the check was credited. For example, okay, if the collecting banker, before he made any payment, before he credit any payment, okay, to account payee, he asked for the bearer account payee identity card. So, dia akan tengok lah whether the same name stated on the check as account payee also name in the identity card. Okay, example of case Far Eastern Bank against B Hong Finance and Co. And in this case, the defendant banks was not negligent because the plaintiff bank had made all inquiries. So they have made proper inquiries that it should reasonably be expected to make. And thus, the plaintiff bank had no right to sue the defendant's bank in covertions. So if the bank had exercised all the reasonable care, they have made the inquiry to the to person, okay, by asking for the IC, okay, so they can rebut the liability for negligence. Okay, so these are the examples of general clauses. As you can see, example of words account payee. So there was a transverse line, ada two transverse lines. Okay, and in between of the lines stated the words account payee, not negotiable, or ENCO. So this is the example of general closing. Okay, this is based on the check. So it cross not negotiable. So it doesn't matter you want to cross it at kat sini ke, okay, ataupun kat sini ke, tengah-tengah ke. So it doesn't matter as long as you cross the check. Okay, so this is an example of not negotiable, and then this is the example of account payee only. Okay, this state kat sini lah. So account payee here means that refer to Roy M. Okay, so only Roy can receive the payment, and the collecting banker will only credit the amounts to Roy's accounts only. Okay, so if the collecting banker disregard the name of account payee here, let's say he paid okay to wrong person without conducting any inquiry, so collecting banker is liable against the true owner of the check. Okay, so please take note. Okay, next we have special closing. Special closing is when the name of a banker is written between the lines or across the face of the check without the lines. Okay, so based on special closings, okay, there are two transverse lines, and then in between there was the name of banker. Banker here is referring to the collecting banker. Okay, and then it also can be across the name of a banker without the lines. So what are the effects? The paying banker must pay the amount of the check only to the collecting banker name in the crossing. So bank yang you akan cross within the lines is the collecting banker. And the negotiability of the check is also restricted. The check can only be negotiated to some person who is a customer of the bank to whom it is crossed. across. Okay, so only the customer of the collecting banker name in the crossing can be credited the amounts of check. Okay, so examples of special crossing when you state the name of the bank, okay, with lines or without any line. Okay, this is an example. Okay, when you cross. Okay, is Asia Bank here is referring to paying banker. Okay, paying bank, and then ABC Bank Limited here referring to collecting bank. Okay, paying is the one who keluarkan check tu lah. Okay, where a person or an owner drawn a check. Okay, next we continue with alteration of check.